Greetings, everybody. I guess this video is going to go up on the Travels with Spy playlist because I don't really have a better place to put it. This is probably going to play out something like an episode of This Old House, except that unlike the hosts of This Old House, I'm actually not an experienced carpenter and not terribly familiar with the material, but I will share what I know. I had a very rare opportunity today to discuss German architecture. I am out in the countryside in the general vicinity of Dresden. We are actually at Feili's family home, and it happens to be an example of the timber frame style of house that some of you have probably seen in movies or literature, pictures maybe, and it's very closely associated with Germany, although it's used in many other parts of the world as well. I just wanted to talk a little bit about this style because for those of you who do find it interesting, this is a chance for me to show an example of just such a house. So let's head on in. Now, this style of house in German is known as Fachwerk, and it's been around for hundreds and hundreds of years, probably more, but it's been in use in Germany for many hundreds of years. And one of the most interesting aspects of it is that these brown timbers here, those are actually part of the house's support structure. So they're not just there for decoration. This house is an example of the half-timbered style, in which these brown timbers here actually bear the weight of the house. They provide the support structure, and then the beige areas in between, which is called infill, that doesn't really support any significant load. They do technically bear some minor load, their own weight, but the support structure itself is provided by those brown beams. And the beige area here, this is covered over in plaster. And underneath the plaster, there can be any number of different things. There can be what's called wattle and daub, which is basically sticks, a framework of sticks, filled in between with mud or clay or some other material that begins wet and malleable and then hardens. Sometimes the infill is brick, sometimes stone, sometimes mortar. So it really varies, and it's different in region to region of Germany as well. They say that there are as many different variations even of the timber-framed, the Fachwerk style, as there are regions of Germany in which they're found. So, for those of you who are wondering a little bit about this type of house and what the deal is with it, why it's so common in any kind of depiction of Germany in literature, this is why. They've been constructed here, I think, from the 11th or 12th century? And many of them have been extensively remodeled. You can see even here that on the eaves there are shingles here. And that's all new. But this house in particular has some examples of some of the older timbers that are still intact. And you can even see under the eaves there, the gutter is new, but the eaves are still they're still composed of the old original timbers. You can see these here as well. Many of these houses have also been expanded, so sometimes the area that is timber framed does not comprise the entire structure. And I'm not sure about this house. This house is very old, I'm told, but I do not know quite how old. Let's take a look inside. I've been very generously granted permission by Feili's family to film here, and I must say her mother in particular, who's been responsible for most of this, has done a very impressive job with the renovations. I'll show some of the newer areas here first, and then some of the older areas as well. What you often see with these houses, and you can see that the ceiling work in here is all new, the light fixtures, these are all new. Everything has been modernized. The kitchen has been modernized. There's, a modern sink. If I could get the camera to focus properly, there we go. Modern stove and oven and range top, even a dishwasher. All of the cabinetry is new. However, you still see the original plaster on the walls. Or maybe not the original plaster, but the original style of plaster. It might have been replastered at some point. All of this is again new. There we go. Very beautiful modern bathroom. But again, the old and the new really come together very nicely here, because you see we have these new marble tiles, and yet behind them, even visible up above them, the old style plaster remains intact. So it's a very, very nice bathroom, modern bathtub, shower stall. The removable shower head is very common in Germany, as is this type of toilet, the ones built into the wall. They're not quite the Japanese ones. There are no bidets or anything like that, but it's a much more modern model than many of the ones you see in the United States. So again, a lot of extensive renovation, remodeling has been done here. These old timber frame houses, many of them survive in almost their original condition, far from cities, because those that existed in cities tended to be bombed out or gutted during the war or afterward. But if you get out into the countryside, you tend to find some really nice examples that are perfectly preserved. And in fact, as I understand it, there's even a tourist road that kind of leads from northwestern to southeastern Germany, where you can follow this road and see that the road goes through villages that are just filled with these old Fachwerk houses. So, very nice. This is the room that I've very generously been offered as a temporary office here. And unfortunately, I'm only going to be here for another few days before Feile and I head back to Bonn. But this room has one of the best examples, one of the best opportunities for me to show the original timbers here. You can see that these beams, these rafters, are hand-hewn. They're all cut by hand, shaped by hand. You can see, if we stand right here and look towards the end, they are not uniform in shape. And we'll move over here to the other one. You can see that all of this work was done, this timber was cut, with very simple tools, axes, adzes, probably cross-cut saws, draw knives, maybe chisels, gouges, but hand tools. And the timber framing style is actually one of the very impressive technological achievements of the ages past, because this style with these beams fits the timbers together in a fashion very much like Lincoln logs, if you're familiar with Lincoln logs. They're fitted together at joints cut into the timbers themselves. So they provide a fairly sturdy framework for a house without even really needing that many nails. Some of them have no nails in them at all. Some of them are so sturdy that they don't need nails to fit together. And the simpler the construction, obviously, the easier it is to build houses like this with only the most basic of tools. So the methods may be primitive, but the skills required to build using those methods are very, very advanced. You have to be a very skilled tradesman or tradeswoman in order to be able to build like this. Another item of note is that the beams here are at about eye level for me. The ceiling in this room is extremely low. The light out there is automatic, by the way. So again, another modern aspect. But the ceiling here is, I can actually touch the ceiling with the top of my head, and I'm about 5'7" or 5'8", give or take. So very low ceilings, very cozy, and a lot of the original plaster is still fairly visible in this room as well. Although again, that goes side by side with some of the more modern renovations. You can see that there are marble window sills and modern storm windows in place here as well, with obviously much newer window panes. See if we can get the camera to focus a bit better on that. Modern light fixtures as well, and of course furnishings. This is soap from Australia. It gets you clean and teaches you about lore while you shower. Great stuff. All right, let's take a look at the attic, because in the attic as well, there are some very interesting vestiges of the original construction of this house. Let's see, there we go, that's the light. The stairs you can see are all new. The floorboard's relatively new. That's corrugate there, it looks like. And then linoleum. But one of the most fascinating things to me about this place is that if you look here, you can see that there was some newer patchwork done on the roof here, but these timbers, these older ones, they do not appear to have been cut by machine, by sawmill. These appear to be, if not original, then at least much older than the rest of the structure. And over here in particular, you can see that this support, this is probably original or close to it as well. And you can see this is, this right here is an iron peg that goes through the entirety of the beam, and it looks like some reinforcement was done here with a newer piece of timber. So, many of the original timbers of the house are still intact, and this one in particular really fascinated me. This very large horizontal beam that, far from being machine cut, it appears to have been, again, hewn by hand, and you can begin to see why some of the reinforcement in here was necessary. These timbers are, they're certainly aging and cracking a little bit. There is, looks like, a nail or two in here, but a very, very old iron nail. So, definitely a vestige of the original structure. And even here, this is one of my favorite things, this old school handmade wooden ladder just sitting here in the attic. You can see even with the woodworking on this ladder, this appears to have all been done by hand. And here you can see an iron brace going through the ladder on this rung, and underneath the rung, in fact. I don't know how good the light's going to be in here. I can never quite tell with this camera. But a very, very old school ladder. The outside edges are still rounded, so it looks like it was just a fairly long beam just split in half, and one side used for one half of the ladder and the other side used for the other half. And it's even missing a rung here. You can see where it apparently broke off, and there's the peg. So a lot of really very fascinating old school pieces of timber in here, and old school construction in general. And yeah, that's just about it. I thought that people might find this interesting. I hope somebody does, because otherwise this is just going to be a long, boring video that nobody wants to watch. But yeah, hopefully somebody will find this interesting. I'm no expert in carpentry, but I hope that sharing what I know has provided some educational incentive. And actually, I'll put some links in the description for those who are interested to more information about the Fachwerk style of construction, and in particular its history, its historic use here in Germany. So that's it, everybody. Thank you all very much for joining me. Again, I hope somebody has enjoyed this and found it worthwhile, and I look forward to seeing all of you next time. Take care, everyone.